listen, so much is happening this week. Like, I can't even concentrate on what I'm supposed to be doing. Harry and Niall are both killing me. They're, like, releasing songs and tour dates and shit like that. This is very unfair. This is not good for my mental health, my physical health, just any kind of health. So yeah, this is a busy week. There's a lot of news, so let's just get right into it. Here's the latest news that's been happening in the past couple days. Okay, Niall is coming out with a second single. So that means when that boy goes on tour, he won't just be performing This Town. Because I'm like, is This Town gonna be the only song that Niall has? Like, is there gonna be like remixes of This Town? But no, Niall has a new single coming out and it's called Slow Hands. And at first I was like, Small Hands? Soft Hands? Like, I couldn't remember the title of it. If it was Small Hands, it'd be written by Donald Trump. I don't know about you guys, but I'm really excited to hear a new single from Niall because This Town came out in 2016. Like, it's been a while. So it's about time. And then if you go to Niall's Twitter, he updated his profile picture and his cover photo to Slow Hands. So yeah, I'm excited. Speaking of new singles, Mr. Harry Styles released a new song today called Sweet Creature. And guys, I heard this at noon today before my class. I was actually considering on skipping class, but nope. I had to be shook and then go to class. But anyway, I don't know about you guys, but when I first heard this song, like the intro, like the guitar part, it really sounded like Blackbird by the Beatles, and I feel like you guys should know that song. It's a classic. It's a very popular Beatles song. So you can definitely see where that inspiration came from when you listen to the song. You can tell that the Beatles was an inspiration for the song. In short, I love it. I'm not really sure if Harry's whole album is going to be a bunch of chill acoustic vibes, or if there's gonna be a mix of like fast tempo stuff, dance music, or whatever. Well, not dance music, but I just mean like faster tempo moving stuff. Okay, this got me emotional for many different reasons. One, Harry Styles is going on tour. I think that just basically sums up the whole thing. But two, I'm kind of confused about the whole promo code thing because someone told me, like, they called Ticketmaster. They said that if you don't get a code on Friday, you can't buy tickets. And I'm like, what the fuck? Like, guys, I'm gonna be so pissed, soy pissed, if I do not get a code on Friday. Like, if my friend gets one and I don't, I'm sorry, I'm taking her ticket. Because I feel like I'm more of a fan than she is. And you know what pisses me off the most? Sorry, I'm getting emotional. I despise the people who are not stands and they get front row seats and they don't even know Harry Styles' goddamn middle name. Bitch, I've been in this fandom since 2012. I'm a hardcore Harry stan, and if I don't get tickets, but a Harry fake stan does, words cannot even, I'd be pissed. Sorry, I had to go on a little rant there because that shit happens all the time. Harry's doing a bunch of small venues to begin with, so tickets are very limited and they're going fast. This also says Harry will be doing a secret gig as part of his album release in London May 13th. Okay guys, you know how April was called Hapril because that was like Harry's month? I think May should be called Hay. Harry is now taking over the month of May as well. Like, Harry might as well just take over the whole year. And it's kind of weird how now Niall decides to promote his second single because it's gonna kind of compete with Harry's single and his whole album and everything he's planning for this tour. But anyway, going back to Harry's secret gig, I'm not really sure if this is confirmed. I'm not really sure if someone made it up. But if it is true, I wanna know where it is, which kind of defeats the point of a secret gig. But if any of you find out where this secret gig is, if it is a thing, record it. I know you're not supposed to, but guess what? They had a Made in the AM album release secret party thing and people were filming it too. And then here's where the number 28 comes in. This is where Harry's extra ass really comes through. So this says he announces his first solo tour on April 28th. The first date is September 19th. His Another Man issue released on September 28th. The two songs he performed were number 2 and number 8 on the album, and he released his first song on April 7th, 2017, and that equals the number 28. I'm sorry guys if that was really confusing, but basically everything that Harry has done for this album, for his songs, just his promo, it all has to do with 28. Like, all these numbers add up to 28, the track 2, the track 8. And let me just talk about track 2 and track 8 for a second. Okay, so track 2 is Sign of the Times, and track 8 was Ever Since New York. Ever Since New York is not a single. It was Sign of the Times and now Sweet Creature. So yeah, if Ever Since New York was a single, it would make sense to perform that with Sign of the Times on SNL. But he intentionally performed number 2 and number 8, even though Ever Since New York is not even a single. Like, he could have performed Sweet Creature on SNL, but he didn't, because he intentionally wanted to do track 2 and track 8 for a reason, because it's the number 28. I know all of this is confusing, this might not even make sense to you, but Harry's ass is extra. He knows that we know. Also, guys, speaking of 28, this says February 8th, 2009 was the day that Harry and Louis went to the Script concert. February 8th, 2-8. Maybe that's why the number 28 is so significant to them, because that's the day that Louis and Harry went to the same concert. That's when fate happened. I mean, to be honest, I don't even know anymore. This also says a physical copy of Harry's album will be included with every ticket purchase for his tour. A CD of Harry's album will be included with every ticket purchase online for his tour. Okay, number one, how do people know this stuff? Like, I don't know who to trust anymore, what update account to trust. But to be honest, this fandom has made me not want to trust anybody, because everybody in this fandom gets my hopes up. Because this person says, most if not all of the North American tour dates have a ticket price range of $59 to $99. And part of me has a hard time believing that too, because it's Harry Styles. I feel like there's gonna be no ticket that's like below $100. And if it is, it's like awful seats. To be honest, I don't even care what seats I get as long as I'm in the same room as Harry Styles. This also says, Two Ghosts was written by Harry when he was 19 or 20. Be prepared to get emotional. Does this person not know that I'm already emotional? I'm already unstable, so whatever Two Ghosts has to offer, I'm ready, but not. Harry did say, though, that there were a few songs on his album that he wrote a few years ago, so maybe that was one of them. But guys, I don't know about you, but I feel like I should stay up all Thursday night to see if I got that code and to purchase tickets right away, because I don't want to take any chances. If I'm off by a second, that could determine everything. That could change my destiny, my fate. Jokes aside, though, if I don't see Harry, I'm genuinely going to be disappointed, because I have never seen One Direction as a whole, and Harry Styles is like my favorite. Sorry to pick favorites, I usually don't like to pick my sons, but seriously, I'm like so excited to see Harry, because I've never seen any of them live. So this will be my dream, and if I don't get the ticket, I don't even want to think about it. Not to sound selfish, but if any of you are willing to give up a ticket for me, that's if I don't get a ticket, I will give my YouTube channel to you. Well, I mean, I don't really know what I would do, but that would be amazing. In particular that really made me feel some feelings. Harry with babies will always be my weakness. This picture of Harry with that baby, like, I can relate to that baby in that moment. That face, though. Also, guys, to make it worse, someone made a Larry Manip of this photo. I can't. Screensaver for days. Guys, I can't even explain it. Like, the Photoshop, the edit, it looks so real. Like, guys, I'm just looking at this Manip and I'm like, that's real, but it's not, and it makes me sad that it's not real. Like, this should be real, right? I'm mad. I'm feeling a lot of things right now, guys. But anyway, this post says, when a talented multimillionaire who has an album and a world tour coming up is holding you, and all you're thinking about is animal crackers. Me as fuck. Except I wouldn't be thinking about animal crackers, but I still identify with that baby. Guys, this baby probably isn't even 2 years old yet, and they already have bragging rights. They could literally be Instagram famous when they're older just by posting this photo. Seriously though, this baby peaked already. They don't have to go to college. They don't have to do anything. Just the fact that they had Harry Styles hold them, they've accomplished life already. I never knew that I would be so jealous of a baby. I think we all are. Harry really never uses social media, and when he does some shady shit. I feel like that's worth mentioning. So if you go to this girl's profile, she's clearly a Larry. She says, if I wasn't a Larry, I would be really confused why Harry and Louis are both so obsessed with making things feel like home. Okay, me too, girl. Speaking of home, though, if you guys listen to Harry's new song, Sweet Creature, he mentions home in about two hearts in one home. Oh my God, I feel like it's so Larry. I tried not to make that song about Larry, but hey, I'm a Larry shipper. But yeah, on her profile, she says, yes, I'm a Larry. So I'm not sure if Harry followed her knowing she was a Larry shipper. Like, I don't know if Harry saw her Larry tweet. But again, I feel like Harry does stuff intentionally. He doesn't just do stuff for the sake of it. He's already stated that. So I feel like there should have been a reason that he followed her. Okay, now this topic I saved for last. Don't know why I saved it last, because it's not the best. By the way, I love all the names that our fandom has given Eleanor, but Elk is my favorite. I love how people call her Elevator as well. So basically, Louis posted this Instagram pic of his shoes, and this should have been a clear indication that some shit was going down. And you might be confused, like, it's a shoe. Well, here's the thing. Before, Louis used to post selfies, and that would be like a warning selfie, but Louis has been liking pictures of shoes, posting shoes, just a lot of stuff about shoes on his Instagram, and we're like, okay, some shit's gonna go down. And well, what do you know? Louis and Eleanor pictures. So this says, like always, when Harry and Louis are in the same city, we get new pictures of Louis and Eleanor together. We're used to this. Yeah, to be honest, when we got Louis and Eleanor pictures, I was just like, eh, like, this happens all the time. We should be used to it. Like, I wasn't even mad at all. I'm, like, laughing at this point. But anyway, Louis and Eleanor were spotted at an Ed Sheeran concert. So this says, Louis at the Ed Sheeran concert wearing a Gucci piece of the Blind for Love collection. Nice choice of clothing, Louis. And here's some more confirmation. It says, it's Ed Sheeran's first night at the O2 tonight and just spotted Louis Tomlinson in the crowd to support. And if you guys look at these photos of Louis and Eleanor, one, Louis is just holding Eleanor's jacket. Two, Ollie is there. And like, look, I understand, isn't Ollie like a bodyguard or like an assistant or something? So that's probably why he's there. But it just seems like Ollie is always there when Louis is with Eleanor. Like, I feel like this is some polyamorous relationship, like some third wheel shit. Like, I've really never seen Louis and Eleanor recently just by themselves. Like, Ollie is always there. And to be honest, you would think that Louis would have way more security than just Ollie, because I think of Ollie more like a friend rather than like an assistant or whatever the fuck he is. After that whole airport incident, you would think that Louis would have way more security. I mean, he's an A-lister celebrity. And plus, Eleanor is not really a celebrity, so you would think they would have a lot of security to protect her as well. Guess not. So here's the part that I want to talk about the most, because this just proves how fake this shit is. So this says, there's literally exits for celebrities, so they're not followed. But he left through the main entrance. That should tell you everything. To sum up what happened with Louis tonight, he was spotted in the middle of the crowd, no security, ditching the VIP section, stayed only a very short time, then left via the main entrance, no security again. He's there to stunt. We know that if he wants to enjoy a concert, especially a friend of his, he will stay in private booths, then leave from back exit, and no one would know he was there. They're literally parading Louis and Eleanor around the concourse in front of all the packed out restaurants at the O2 during a sold out Ed Sheeran concert on bank holiday. So organic and natural, and not like he could leave through a back door, though. They just left through the main entrance. The Facebook friend who was there said instead he was going back and forth and then left before the concert ended. So basically, they didn't give a fuck about the concert, were just there to be seen. Okay, organic. Yeah, she kept writing when he'd go and come back, and he did it a couple of times to get something to drink before he finally left a little before the concert ended. Can we just take a moment of silence for all the bullshit that is Louis and Eleanor? Because seriously, guys, I'm not even mad. Like, I'm mad, but like, I'm not mad. You know, like, it's that feeling like when you know that something is just so bullshit and it's so laughable, but people are still trying to make it look like it's real, but you're just sitting back like, bitch, we can see through that shit. That's where I am right now with this whole Louis and Eleanor stuff. I'm not even mad when I see them together anymore. I am just like, okay, bitch, bring me the photos. Let me see that shit. Let me see how convincing you're trying to make this shit now, because I'm not convinced. Like, guys, at this point, we're bigger than this. We're stronger than this. We can see through this. This is just unbelievable. This is laughable at this point. If anything, we shouldn't even give this attention. I know I'm giving it attention by making a video about it, but actually just feel sorry for them. I feel sorry for Eleanor, the waste of time that this whole thing is, the fact that Louis has to stunt. Guys, if Louis really did sign a contract to be with Eleanor, he basically only signed it to like hold her jacket. And I find that to be the funniest shit ever. So Louis also posted this other picture on Instagram, and look at his sweatshirt. It is a French sweatshirt. And who was just in France for an interview? I think Harry is now in London. By the way, Louis is in London too. But like literally Harry was just in France, like, and now Louis is just wearing this sweatshirt. Like, I feel like Harry bought that for him and no one can convince me otherwise. And plus guys, if you look at the French on his shirt, I think that translates to likes boys or as boys or something like that. It's probably not a gay reference, but I mean, come on Louis, out of all the writing that you could have chose. Whatever, aside from what's written on it, just the fact that it's a French sweatshirt and Harry was just there and Louis was now seen with it. It's called connecting the dots. Also guys, this says, hold up, Louis is wearing Gucci shoes with bees on them. And we all know the significance of the bee. Harry just got a new bee tattoo. And also, Louis always says, I'm buzzing.
So I'm buzzing.
And as I've stated before, there were many Larry shippers who were saying that they were gonna get a bee tattoo. So it's kind of like a fandom thing, and they wouldn't know about that unless they were searching through our tag. But guys, no, seriously, look at Louis' shoes. They have bees on them. This also says, both Louis and Harry will be at the Met Gala. Only Harry will be seen in public. There will be proof of Louis being there too. Harry is going to the Met Gala and not alone. I hope he wears Gucci. Harry and Louis in matching Gucci B shoes that comply to their respective tastes. So guys, number one, it's a B. Number two, the fact that Harry was recently just wearing shoes with like bees on them and now Louis is, like, they have this B theme going on and this whole French theme going on. This says, Harry gets a new B tattoo. Louis wears B sneakers. Harry travels to Paris for interviews, and then Louis wears a sweater that has a French sentence. And then to top it all off, Phoebe Tomlinson goes on Snapchat and she posts a picture of her sibling with a bee pacifier. And that was all during the same time. Is this a coincidence? Like, what is with all this bee stuff around the same time? I don't know what else to say. This can't be a coincidence. This has to be intentional on Louis and Harry's part. They are trying to send us a signal. They knew that there'd be some bullshit going down, so they're like, oh, the fans see everything, they know what's going on, so we're gonna subtly tell them via clothing style. Cause see, Harry and Louis don't do the whole rainbow bondage bear thing anymore, so they're trying to find other ways to be subtle and show us. If you ask me, this whole thing is entirely extra. Pathetic, sad person. Okay, look, I'm not making this video to roast Daisy. I'm not one to make fun of a child because I think that's wrong. The fact that she would call someone pathetic and sad for just posting a Larry photo or making a Larry photo. Like, even if you're not a Larry shipper, like, that photo was fucking cute. It was also creative. Like, whoever illustrated that is talented. Like, Daisy is showing a little bit of homophobia. So I guess a person is pathetic and sad for just thinking that two people are together who are the same sex. Okay. It's not like the person posted a whole paragraph ranting why Larry shippers are the best and why everybody else is really stupid. And I don't get why Daisy would go out of her way to tell somebody that they're pathetic and sad. To be honest, like, I don't even want to believe that this is the real Daisy, because as far as we know, the whole Tomlinson family is really nice. And I don't want to believe that Daisy and Phoebe are these people who just try to debunk Larry any chance they get. Because if Larry's not real, why would you, like, go out of your way to, like, do that? To be honest, I don't care what Daisy said. The fact that we get all this other shit that doesn't even seem like a coincidence, I'm still gonna believe in Larry, and I'm still gonna believe that all the Louis and Eleanor stuff is bullshit. The fuck? I don't know, some people have been saying that their kid's name is Taylor, and then other people have been saying it's Bear. I really hope it's Taylor. But I mean, I will admit, Bear Payne still sounds better than Northwest. Anything will beat Northwest. Any Anyway, guys, this was a really long video. Hopefully everything made sense. So leave all your thoughts down below. And like always, I make a video whenever I want, so like and subscribe. All my social media is down in the description. And I will see you guys later. Bye.
My honey bun sugar plum, pumpy yum pumpkin, you're my sweetie pie.